So, Mark, how do we calibrate dating methods?
Well, the only way you can really calibrate a dating method is to have an object with a known age. And this is very difficult when you're dealing with things that are millions of years, apparently, old, because how do we know the age of something? But you can get rocks of known age.
So how do we get a rock of known age?
Well, one good way is to take a rock sample from the lava dome of a volcanic eruption, which has a known date. So there's a radiometric clock called the potassium-argon clock. And potassium decays into argon with a certain time constant. It's very long. It's like 1.5 billion years approximately. But argon is an inert gas. And so when the lava is molten, the gas will escape. It'll bubble out of the molten lava. But then as it sets into a solid rock, the argon is trapped. And if you like, the potassium argon clock then starts ticking. So you're not measuring the age of the lava per se, you're measuring the date upon which it solidified and became a rock. And that date we can observe because we know the date the eruption took place. Some historian, an eyewitness, saw it and wrote the date down.
So an eyewitness is always crucial when calibrating.
Before we continue, a quick heads up. Stick around until the end of the interview because we'll be offering an exclusive free ebook, The Creation Answers Book, packed with biblical answers to over 60 important questions about creation, evolution, and the Bible. You won't want to miss it. Now, back to the interview.
Absolutely, and I think it comes back to that all the time. It's the eyewitness historical record, which is the has to be the authority in all matters of history. So let's take some examples. Mount St. Helens erupted in 1980 in Washington State in the US. Some rock from the lava dome was sampled in a number of different places and in different ways. And those samples sent off to different dating laboratories and they were potassium argon dated. Now the laboratory didn't know where they'd come from, but they knew that the scientist expected that there would be very little argon present in the samples, which is kind of a cue that says, you know, be really careful when you're looking to detect the amount of argon. And back came a range of dates that were anywhere from 350,000 years to 2.8 million years old. And yet those rocks were only at the time about 10 years old.
Wow.
So this shows you that there's obviously a problem here because potassium argon is giving false dates for rocks with a known age.
So how can we trust these dating methods if when they're tested with rocks of known age, they're coming back inaccurate? How do we trust them when they're testing something of an unknown age?
That's a very, very good point. And that's the whole issue behind this, I believe. Look, there are a lot of other illustrations where this sort of thing has happened. In New Zealand, there's a volcano there called Mount Naruhoe. And those of us who might be Lord of the Rings fans might recognise it as Mount Doom. But this volcano erupted in 1954 and then again in the early 1970s. I think it was 1975 from memory. And rock from those lava flows, which were distinct lava flows, were once again dated using potassium argon, and dates were completely wrong. The rocks were only a few decades old, but once again they came back with ages of many millions of years, clearly not correct. And it's not just those examples. There's in Hawaii, for instance, Kilauea is a volcano which actually has been erupting in relatively recent past. There was a large eruption about 200 years ago. Rock from the lava dome there was dated into millions of years again. And Hualalai is another example in Hawaii. And so the list goes on. So when we're looking for a rock of known age, we find that the dating methods don't stack up. At the very least, they should come back and say there is an undetectable amount of argon in this sample. So it must be very young, beyond the capability of our dating method. But that's not what comes back. What comes back is a clear date with error bars, suggesting that they've detected argon, they've measured the ratio of potassium to argon, and so why should it not be a legitimate date? and yet it's known to be wrong. So these dating methods are fraught with difficulties. You know, these long time constants, we need to think about them a bit. 1.4 billion years for potassium argon. It's a bit like trying to measure a 100 meter sprint using a calendar, if my analogy makes any sense. What you need is a stopwatch, which can measure fractions of a second, isn't it? But a calendar is a very coarse measuring device. It's okay if you want to measure something which is hundreds of years ago, you can use a calendar. That's a great idea. Like another example, how long did Queen Elizabeth II reign? 70 or so years. How do we know? We use a calendar. But if you're trying to measure a 100 meter sprint, then the calendar is a useless device. So a radiometric measuring scheme, which has a time constant measured in billions of years, is incapable of measuring things which are only thousands. But here's the problem. The Bible says that the earth is in fact only thousands of years old. So there's a fundamental incompatibility, I believe, between these long age dating methods and the actual age of the earth.
If you've enjoyed watching this, you're going to want to check out the Creation Answers book, packed with biblical answers to over 60 important questions about creation, evolution, and the Bible. And if you want to get a copy of the free ebook, follow the link in the description.